governments work for each other. They all work together. They all are one. If you look up the peace treaty for Antarctica, you will see that they all agreed to that no one can go to Antarctica. So if you can do that, how the hell you can't stop going to war with each other? That is because they're not really at war with each other. They're just collecting lost souls. Look up the word soldier, break it up in two, and you will see soul dire.
It's like nobody at the moment is cottoning on to the fact that we are the souls within an AI system. You feel tired internally, that's your soul. Our bones are calcium. Calcium is a metal. Our muscles, our cells, our central nervous system are electric. And what we've got at the moment is all the controlled oppositions, the likes of the Bob Proctors, the Greg Bradens, you name them, Dolores Cannon, they're all promoting the system, manifesting this. And what that's doing is that's bonding you to the system, electrically tethering you to the system, to the universe. You don't get a voice, a blue tick, or influence if you're not against the system. I've been banned 6 times in 18 months. I'm shadow banned now. If this goes viral, then fuck me, something's changed. Don't you find it really weird how many big influential people are pushing the simulation theory? Just have a quick look at this picture before I come on screen. Okay, so you've had a look. It's really interesting that all the pyramidal structures located across the Earth are actually in alignment with stars. It's almost like they're harnessing and being a conduit for electromagnetic energy. There is a nefarious agenda behind the simulation theory, and it's very dangerous. We are souls caught in this system. Our souls are not our thoughts. It's not our brain, it's our energy. So, what this is doing is pushing people into their minds, buying into the end agenda, which is total soul suppression, total AI augmentation, as above, so below. Don't even find it weird that the pyramid and the New World Order and the eye, sure, it's just a coincidence, right? So ancient AI has been controlling this optical illusion for a millennia. Now there's a big difference between a computer game and an optical illusion, and like a mirage in the desert if you get lost, and we've seen those in films, right? So manipulation of light, the illusion that we live within, is a physical manipulation of electromagnetic energy controlled by ancient AI.
Proving that space is fake with a deck of cards. Now, this is just not any deck of cards. This is the Illuminati card game of conspiracy made in 1995, and it costs about $1,500. Now, let's take a look at some of these cards made in 1995. Terrorist nuke, Pentagon. Here's a real good one. Quarantine. What did the world just go through? Y'all remember the oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico? Now, before I go any further, I gotta explain to the simple-minded what predictive programming is. It's essentially a set of planned events that they program into your subconscious mind through things like this prior to them happening. They've been trying to do this one for quite some time, eh? Now, this is why everyone's like, The Simpsons predicts everything. No, it is not a prediction. It is an agenda. Now they do this because they are essentially disclosing and telling you what they are going to do previous to them doing it. And this alleviates their karma. Let's take a look at some more of these cards. International Weather Organization, geoengineering, chemtrails. Remember the nuclear accident? The Boston Marathon bombing? Here's one of my favorites, flat earthers. People laugh, but the flat earthers know something. I wonder what we know. Maybe that we're not on a ball spinning at 1,000 miles per hour, orbiting the sun at 67,000 miles per hour, and hurling through space at millions of miles per hour. Here's a cool one, science fiction fans. That's what you guys are. And one of my favorites, NASA. Y'all remember that song, Californication, by the Red Hot Chili Peppers? Space might be the final frontier, but it's made in a Hollywood basement. They put these things in your face, and you guys don't even pick up on it. The eyes are useless when the mind is blind. Peace and love.
Next, we're going to talk about how Millie Bobby Brown isn't the smartest cookie in the box. The young star went on record saying that she believes the Earth is flat. For most of us, the whole flat Earth concept is pretty ridiculous at this point because we have extensive research and even photos from space to disprove it. But Millie has decided none of that matters to her, and she continues to be a flat earther. This is quite alarming for parents whose young children look up to the teenage actress and teachers who are trying to convey facts.
Space is fake. The universe is a realm. The moon is a spaceship. Reptilians are real. Direct energy weapons are thousands of years old. They are currently destroying the planet. That's why all the earthquakes and tornadoes and hurricanes and forest fires are happening. It's intentional. It's technology. Because we're figuring everything out. Why do you think 3 or 4 years ago, when everyone was starting to wake up, all of a sudden they locked us down, made us stay in our houses, made us stay 6 feet apart so that our bioelectric fields wouldn't touch each other so we couldn't pray effectively? And they're like, okay, the Great Reset, everyone's gonna eat bugs now. Just like in the Talmud. They predicted it in the Talmud. They said the Goyim wouldn't eat meat. This is a prison. The beast system. Think about that. What is a system for beasts? For domesticated beasts? That's called a farm. We live on a farm. The whole earth is a beast system. The mark of the beast is 666 carbon. And the mark of the beast on your forehead and your hand isn't just metaphorical about your thoughts and actions, it's also VR and your cell phone. Because they want to put us all in pods, and I'll tell you why. Scientists recently discovered that stress emits static electricity off of your body. It literally breaks open the superconductive channels of your bioelectric field. It makes you give off electricity that's yours. That's why all black magic is rooted in chaos to break your concentration and stress you out. That's what an energy vampire is doing. Breaking your superconductor channel and then siphoning off your energy. Well, that's what the Matrix is, right? They put you in pods to collect your electricity, and guess what else? Your processing power. That brain inside of your skull is way more powerful than any quantum computer they can make in the same size. And they're running out of silicone. They can't produce it fast enough for their blockchain cryptocurrency, which also, folks, is not good. Trust me. So they're going to daisy chain our quantum computer brains into a massive supercomputer. And we're going to emit electricity from the stress they're going to put us in those VRs. That's why hell is going to feel like 1,000 years. It's not actually going to be 1,000 years. That's why also you'll wish for death, but it won't come because you'll be in a simulation. They're going to simulate hell to make you stressed out to emit that electricity and then use your brains as processing power to power whatever machines they have. This is the war at the end of time, by the way. The dragon's probably going to be a nanomachine AI robot that literally looks like a dragon. Everyone who got the pop, pop, jab, 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 they're all going in the pods, folks. They're making them electrical. They're making them more efficient for the electricity and the processing power. I just told you everything. And what's happening now is they're going to literally reset the Earth like they did during Tartaria because we keep remembering. Every time we remember too much, they destroy us. Just like the Tower of Babel. That's what that's all about. The Tower of Babel is about those evil monster aliens that destroyed people who finally woke up.
There's the truth about reality and spiritual awakenings. Do you know why it's called a spiritual awakening? You are awakening to the fact that you are a spirit and this reality is a video game. It is a matrix. Physicists and scientists and the people in control are giving you hints and clues right in front of your face that we live in a holographic simulated universe. And if you have been going through a spiritual awakening so far, you have likely seen repeating numbers and experienced deja vu over and over again. This is because this matrix is glitching. What that really means is that your spirit, your soul, is syncing up with the mathematic coding of the universe. The universe is just a very, very complex quantum computer. So when you spiritually awake, you are aware that this avatar is not you. You are your soul. Whatever consciousness is controlling this body, that is the real you. And because so many of the souls that plugged into this matrix got addicted to the game, because this game is kind of fun, especially if you're a multimillionaire or billionaire, you get to control the world, they have forgotten their link to their higher self. The higher self that is outside of this matrix, that is in the real world. Don't lie to yourself. You've always thought that this reality was a little bit bizarre. Especially after your spiritual awakening, you have realized that there's something kind of off about this reality. It's because it's not the real one, and your soul knows it. Now you're probably asking, how the hell do I get out of the matrix? Because I'm tired of it. If there's one thing Buddhism got right, it's detachment. When you have realized this is a game, you've already beat the game. Now it's time to unplug yourself, unplug your consciousness, your subconsciousness from this realm. Stop playing the game. You've already beat it. Stop getting attached to material things. Don't obsess over things. Don't feel envy. Don't feel greed. Because when you get attached, you're still immersed in the game. It's gonna get harder for you to get out. Now, the elite, the ones in control, are the pro players of this game. They control everything. They are the ones that I like to call the cheaters. They know this game through and through. They likely are the ones who created it in the first place. And they like it here. They don't want to give it up. This is where Satanism comes in. Satanism is not worshiping the devil. It's worshiping the ego. This is their kingdom and they don't want to leave it. Why do you think they're creating the metaverse? Why do you think they're trying to recreate another matrix? Because they know masses of us are waking up and they're going to lose the population because so many of us don't want to be here anymore. So they're going to get as many souls as they can to suck back into another matrix. This realm is not going to be here. I don't know how long it's going to take, but we all feel it in our soul that there's going to be a huge reset.
When you die, you have choices. You don't know this, but you have choices. When you leave your physical body, it is very typical for you to see yourself standing next to your body with either your loved ones or EMTs or whatever the circumstances are. And you see yourself, and then you'll hear a voice, you'll see the tunnel of light, and the voice will be calling you, or you will hear the voice telepathically telling you to come on, come, you know. Now, as you stand there and you're looking at the tunnel of light, you have a choice. You can go up to this tunnel of light where you'll be with other loved ones that have crossed over usually, all right? And you'll be put into a system where you are essentially caught in a reincarnational cycle, a loop. Or you can turn around, put the tunnel of light behind you, and what you will see is the entire universe.
You can't make me do anything, Chris.
Choice. The problem is choice. The problem is choice. The problem is choice.
Meet Oliver Schwab. He is the managing director of the World Economic Forum. His sister, Nicole, is a member of the executive committee for the World Economic Forum. In July of 2021, she said that was a huge opportunity to have their Great Reset.
I see it as a tremendous opportunity to really to have this Great Reset and to use this huge flows, you know, of money, to use the increased levers that policymakers have today in a way that was not possible before.
Their father, Klaus Schwab, is the founder of the World Economic Forum. 7 years ago, he announced plans to start tracking the entire population and merge everyone with a central machine, what he now calls the Great Reset. The Schwab family is working together with other families because that's how Team Evil works. You can call them the Illuminati if you like, but they have no official name and they are not illuminated. There is no telling how many family bloodlines are involved, but they keep it in the family for three main reasons, and they all have to do with power. First, and most simply, as a way to gain and maintain their fortune. Secondly, is to carry out long-term secret objectives. These families use insurance companies and private trusts to protect their own fortune from the fiat debt-based system that they created and to generate the kind of money needed for a 100-year plan. The older generation outlawed, introduced petrochemical pharmaceuticals and polluted the environment. And now the younger generation is here to fix it with their totalitarian Great Reset. It's a multi-generational plan that works because of family loyalty and also because of the third reason why they keep it in the family, trauma-based mind control. Most victims of the CIA's trauma-based mind control program, MKUltra, have come from families with a history of child abuse, because multi-generational child abuse makes a child more susceptible to mind control. And most of the characters we see as world leaders are not only actors on a stage, they are oblivious because they have suffered a lifetime of abuse and mind control. The overwhelming majority of people on Team Evil are not all in on it. They simply do as they are told. They follow orders and they don't ask questions. These families see having children as a means of gaining power and wealth. They see their own children as property, as slaves to do the family's bidding. But perhaps it's more like a cult than a family. Nearly a million child orphans were distributed throughout America and the Commonwealth in the late 1800s by an international secret society called the Odd Fellows. Delivered primarily by train, many of these orphans were born in private homes owned by the Odd Fellows and their offshoot, the Daughters of Rebecca, an all-female Masonic organization that featured symbols of mass breeding and fertility. Philip Eugene de Rothschild says that the Rothschild family alone has produced over 100,000 children in these secret breeding programs. Most of the U.S. presidents during this time were Freemasons. Four of them were Odd Fellows. And at last count, 34 U.S. presidents are directly related to Charlemagne, King of the Franks, who is believed by these Illuminati bloodlines to be of the Merovingian bloodline, a genetic set that they highly value. And Team Evil has always been obsessed with genetics. So it really isn't that strange to point out the similarities between Justin Trudeau and Fidel Castro, Angela Merkel and Adolf Hitler's mother, Barbara Bush and Aleister Crowley, or even Obama and Akhenaten. The only way these families and their abused mind control minions are able to control the rest of us is by dividing us. And if we the people could change that, then we could change everything.
I don't